earth. We're finding all sorts of cool treasure. We found the littlest teapot.
Ladies and gentlemen, we just showed up at Cerro Gordo uninvited. We're also getting ready to go 900 feet below the ground in the Union Mine. First time down wasn't smooth at all. You know, we actually had to get out of the cage, use a sawzall, cut off part of the guide rail to let the cage pass by some tight spots. But I think we got those tight spots taken care of for our trip down.
That's the only other time you've been?
Only once. So there's no necessary guarantee that we're gonna make it all the way down.
Did you bring your sawzall?
I did not bring
your
sawzall.
We'll take one down. I'll get one out of the tools. We have to, actually that reminds me, I should bring a harness too, because let's say we do get stuck, what you have to do, I will probably do it, unless you guys feel comfortable. You have to get in a harness, tie yourself into the cage, go underneath the cage, then you have all the exposure below you to then cut yourself free and let the cage pass.
Nice. Let's go. Okay, so well, guys, obviously you've seen us explore mines before, and those were mines where we could just kind of walk in, walk out. This mine, we are literally at the mercy of what this big old elevator wants to do. Lots of old parts, lots of old metal, lots of old stuff rubbing on each other, and if today's the day they don't want to rub on each other anymore, we're going to be the first ones to find out. So
lots of old stuff rubbing on each other, huh?
All right, so fun turn of events here. Since we showed up and surprised Brent with the 5-ton, he has decided to surprise us with a ride down to the 900-foot level of the Union Mine. Why is this important? Well, because Brent has only been down there one time ever. This will be Brent's second trip, mine and Dave's first trip down. We've got the whole crew here. We got the hoist operator. We got Tim. We got Brent's whole crew of guys that are very familiar with this. Hey, Brent, when was the hoist built? Okay, so this hoist that we're getting ready to trust with our lives, taking us down underground, was built in the 1800s. So big old iron winch line. Look at that bad boy. So basically the way this is gonna work, this is nuts. The hoist operator sits right here. And this big brake right here is what controls the speed of the drum. Here's the hydraulics that control the big hydraulic motors over there that control this giant drum getting us up and down. Guys, this is freaking wild. I'm literally like ecstatic right now because we will be the first people to have been down here. I bet you maybe 10 people have been down to this level in the last 100 years. And rumor has it, below this level is another 1,100 foot level that is supposedly accessible from this level. Who knows if we'll find it, but if we do, it's gonna be awesome. So take a look at all this old equipment, show you what we are trusting our life with here. It's pretty awesome. Another thing I just learned is that as we go down, they've got a big bucket of grease and oil and stuff. They're gonna be greasing all this up as we go because apparently they don't run it often enough to be able to grease it like super regularly. So we're gonna maintain it while we go. This is awesome. Buckle up, guys, because this is going to be a very interesting video. Yeah. I'm Brent.
Worst case?
Worst case scenario, if the old elevator gets stuck, We've got a sawzall. I feel so good.
I've been dreaming about this since
we came here. I'm so stoked. Give you guys a little POV there. That's what we're working with.
On our way down.
We are currently, this is really bright.
Thank you.
We're just about to level 86. I would be lying if I said I thought it was going to go fast. Didn't think it was going to go this slow. Actually, right there, there we go. Good lighting. It's a little too harsh. Just shine it though.
No less, turn it down.
It just made a awful noise that I didn't like at all.
Why are you doing that?
That was me that time.
Silly goose. All right, so as you can see, tension's already running pretty high here in the elevator down to level 900.
Which is the roof, man.
We're just about to 86.
A few inches later.
This is freaking nuts, awesome. Brent. I mean, dude, looking at how they had to stack timbers the whole way.
The entire way down.
At least it's a roomy shaft.
Yeah, spacious.
Brent, have you ever had three people in here?
Luckily, in a GoPro, it probably looks like we're far apart from each other.
No, it's a tight quarters for
first time for three.
For three, people. And we got a decent amount of time going down.
Yeah, so we're about 3 minutes into the trip, and we have about an hour left. We're about 57 minutes, and our walkie-talkies are still working, which is nice. When did the walkie-talkies quit on the before?
So
still got you, loud and clear.
Before we had to use lights the whole time, but these ones should go all the way to the 900.
Yeah.
Have you looked on all the?
We already got in a little argument, so that's good. We got that out of the way. It's making some weird bopping noises, but other than that, we're still trying to look for the cool stuff.
Much, much, much later.
This is rad.
What are you looking at?
The bottom of the shaft, but not quite the bottom of the shaft.
Just a 900. We're not even to level 86 yet. Which is kind of weird, because I feel like we should be. Definitely feels like we're more than 100 feet. Maybe we pass it.
I'm just following tailings.
Still got a copy, Jimbo?
Oh, not following the vein. Look, there's the vein.
What's the gauge say?
About 3 minutes ago, you guys were at 250.
Oh, we're making good time then.
250?
Probably around 300, I would guess.
Damn.
We can barely see it from here.
What is that what Brian's saying, or is that what they're guessing?
Is that what Brian's saying, or are you just guessing?
275, to be exact.
Oh.
Wonderful, thank you.
So we've been here about 15 minutes-ish, maybe 20. They're about 400 feet down, so creeping up on halfway. Still see a faint light down there. We still got good radio communications, so... all is good, I guess, till it's not. I can't stop thinking about you just sneezing and falling off in there, making me nervous.
I'm feeling super lightheaded. I think you should lean forward more.
Yeah, go ahead and just dangle your feet off there. Making me sick.
Johnny took a running jump over this last time we were down there.
Oh.
And then he climbed down the ladder down to 86 feet.
I want to do
without
that.
Without a rope.
I'll climb down the ladder.
So I got to do a, let's see, turn this off real quick. I got to do a quick plug for one of our sponsors, which is Rugged Radios. Dave, let me see that light.
You want to turn down a little bit?
Right there, let's see. Turn down a bit. So Brent and his crew have some long range radios that work pretty good. However, as of right now, the communication is working better with our Rugged Radio. We got much more clear sound. For example.
Can you have me a long antenna on your radio?
long ass antenna. So we're like level maybe 300, 400 by now. And watch, I'm gonna make a call to Jim. Hey Jimbo, can you confirm that you hear me?
Yeah, I read you. You read me?
Wow.
Loud and clear. So that's awesome. That's pretty awesome. So Rugged Radios, big shout out to you. Also Rugged Radios. You might want to look into sending Brent some radios.
Send
right?
Some radios.
Coming on
400. Wow.
100. Can't quite see it on the old phone. Can't quite see the top. But we're in here. Ooh, is that a crush?
Yeah, look at that.
That's coming back with us. Strawberry crush.
Oh, that looks delicious. Try it. See if it's still good.
Hey, well, how's my light doing? Is my light doing good on here?
It's doing great, yeah.
Doing good things?
Hey, Dave, your cable's getting pretty weird. You guys got a copy? Everything okay? Well, we're sitting here, and they just passed the 700-foot level. And his cable has been...
We heard you barely.
His cable's been perfectly still the whole time.
Now it's starting to bang around.
Just as they hit 700 feet, the cable just started banging around all over the place and getting real...
Squirrely. Weirdly enough, Bad Boy and Jackknife Jim are in charge of safety on this trip.
Yeah.
Oh, I hate that so much. It's not even...
No, I hate looking at it, but I feel fine.
That's the worst part, looking at it, because if you were just sitting there, wouldn't think anything else different.
Yeah, our phone.
Man, they are way down there. Oh yeah, that's good.
That's
good. Okay, keep pulling it there.
That is bonkers, everybody.
I really want to go down the ladder. It looks super well built.
It's the coolest.
Look at the back in the day, the bell system.
So when we get back to the top,
cool. I'll show you that. Photo in a picture from the 1800s.
Really?
Yeah. Pretty sweet.
Hey, he's back.
Just had to cool off, I guess.
Okay, well. So, here we go.
Here's your brain bucket.
Buckets of fun.
Roar.
2 to 4 bells is 900. Cage capacity. 4 men only. We were under capacity.
So are we good to leave stuff right here then?
Yeah, they're not taking it off.
Is this a...
Ooh! What's that? Is that the ore cart?
Yeah, ore cart.
Ah. Hold on a second.
That's...
How heavy is it?
Wait.
YouTube's been here. check, radio check. Check, radio check. Dude, what the hell are we talking? Look at that, like, railroad track crossroads. All right, we got plenty of battery in GoPros.
You want your brain bucket?
Nah, I'm good for a second. I mean, like, if it gets real wild, we will. How heavy is this?
Pretty heavy.
So, there's an ore cart down here. There's an old ore cart that we really want to try to take to the top.
We'll find a way.
I don't think it's too heavy. I think if we could probably finagle it. Probably clean up some of these fallen timbers over here, because obviously that used to come down to the track, right?
Yep, that'll go right into the cage.
So we could move some of this stuff pretty easily. And
Is there water down here?
I'm pretty sure that I'm not going to let us leave here until we bring up that ore cart. We might tie the ore cart to the bottom of the elevator and take it up with us. We'll
awesome.
See. Let's go see.
Which way do I go first?
This way out.
You go that way first?
Yeah. Which way you want to go?
Let's go right.
Here we go.
Okay,
all right. Here we go. I'll bring it through. That way, if the light fades, you know
I'm going. It's completely different rock down here. Yeah. Like this, like bedrock. Like this is like solid, heavy duty stuff.
Yabba dabba do. Yeah, like every level feels a little bit different.
Yeah. Look at that guy.
I don't know.
Somebody. Holy crap, this is nuts.
July 16th.
So coming up on our first collapse here, our first cave in. This probably wasn't a collapse. This was probably stuff they mucked and never hauled out.
You know, or they backfilled it in there because they didn't want to take it out.
Right.
You know, imagine having to take weeks to 900 feet back up.
Yeah, no thanks. Is this dead end over here?
No, keep going. It's, so the thing that interests me about this level, it's like all of these water signs. You see these?
Right, yeah.
Water to 700. 700 is where I get water now, you know.
Do you have a gas meter? Drink four gas?
So
old sticks of dynamite right there.
You say dynamite?
Yeah, we're just not going to even play with those.
Give him some space.
Yep. Dynamite deserves all the space that it wants. This is just like a Disneyland ride, dude.
Trying to take about 900 feet underground. It's an old powder room, like dynamite room, because of the door they would put that on there to keep people out of there.
Yeah. Have you gone back in there?
No, I don't think so.
See if we can avoid stepping on any sticks of live dynamite. Much better. Yeah. All right, so currently we are in a powder room, which is where they used to keep the dynamite and stuff, and we're going to try our hardest to not step on any old unstable nitroglycerin.
I don't like it. I don't like it.
Oh boy.
Keep going?
Yeah. Have you been through here yet?
No.
All right. Good
Uncharted
news.
Uncharted territory.
Uncharted territory. We just walked into what we thought was a powder room, but keeps going. So we're going to go.
Mm-mm. No. No. No, no, no.
I think that's the end of the road. Maybe.
Four of mine is 1150, but what it is, they took the 900 down and they had a fault. So then they went off to the sides and they went around it to try to drive it lower.
Yeah.
But nobody, from my understanding, has been able to find their way into the 1150 level.
All right.
Main light died, so we're going to be...
All right, so this is kind of the end of the road here. This is a super soggy part where you can see it's caved in before. Obviously, a lot of moisture still.
A lot of it's so muddy down here. Yeah. Town of the water.
Wonder whether that's true or not. Yeah, that is just full collapse right there.
It'd be interesting when we go back up, we can look at the map, you know?
Yeah.
Dynamite.
Talk to me.
Lots of, unexploded dynamite.
And are you going to touch it?
That's what people want to know.
That's why.
In your comments below, should he touch it?
What's going on with this? What's going on with that?
Look at him change the subject, America.
Yeah,
look at this.
Like,
no, yeah, every voice in my head right now is telling me,
touch it.
Hey man, what's it feel like?
You are.
I mean, it's pretty unstable, right?
The dynamite?
Yeah.
Anyways, I'm...
Well, I think maybe one person should touch it.
It's dangerous thing down here next to the dynamite, because that thing... So, if you light dynamite on fire, it doesn't explode. Right. It needs an impact to impact the nitroglycerin to blow up. So, this goes into that, And that blasting cap is the thing that's way down in the dynamite, and then that pops, and then that pops the dynamite. Mm-hmm. But these things, if you ever see old miners that are missing a finger, it's because of blasting caps.
Really?
Because if you start messing around with those, you play with this, it'll like blow off the finger.
Jeez. So.
Wait, this one says stop. Stop it. Get some help.
Where does I stop?
Stop.
Where are we stopping?
Should we not go any further?
Try again. Dang
it! Break my ankle.
It's a 20-pound hammer.
Yay!
Oh! Hey. Got a little bit.
Oh, that's embarrassing.
Oh!
Oh!
Yeah. Oh! Just about.
You stand up straight right now.
Yeah, straight. I'm stretching. Hey, the exit's this way, Dave.
Is that down the exit side?
Yeah. Oh, that's a nice door. Wait.
Look, got a broom handle on the wall.
Broom handle? Oh, yeah.
Telephone signals.
Oh yeah, that's the one. The blue sign is the one I'll show you a photo of that's in black and white. It's pretty crazy. Really crazy.
That must have been Nimison.
Maybe I should get that going again.
Yeah, that would be cool.
It might work.
1889?
Damn.
Wow.
Coral Bay.
That's cool.
29. I didn't even see that last time. 1929.
1889.
It's a new record, right?
Yeah.
Until we got 88 right there.
Oh.
And here's an 80. Could be 88, could be 82.
Damn.
Except that says 1982. Here's some carbide.
Oh yeah, the old carbide tin.
Yeah.
There you go.
You been down this way yet?
Yes, I've been this way, but I haven't been. It goes right. I didn't go right. I trusted this guy that there's nothing to the right. And this guy is not the most agile.
Definitely had. Are those water lines?
Oh yeah,
I put
the tools.
Oh yeah, that's right. It's so wet back here.
Is that the fault of it? I think so, yeah.
Wow, it's roomy down here. Yeah, you got a right, a left, and a center, and a steady drip.
Oh yeah.
There's a lot of water down here. So you went right.
I did not go right.
Oh, you didn't go right. You
no,
went
I
left.
Sent this guy. I went left. This guy went left, right, and then I trusted him that there's nothing there. But
anybody go straight?
I went straight. Yeah. I would say we go right.
All right. Right. Choose the right. You want to take the lead?
You got it.
Right.
Feel like. I promise there's an egg up here, guys.
Okay, I'm following you, man. I trust you.
I'm the fastest swimmer
up here.
Oh.
Oh, monster. Oh, mother.
Something there at one point. That way?
Ooh,
yeah, it goes farther back to that right, too.
That's crazy because I'm way into cool stuff. All right.
Wow. It keeps opening up. Okay.
blasting caps all over the place, so watch out for those. Don't want anybody losing a finger. There's an old carbide tin. Pretty cool. Tobacco.
Grandma might send some stuff down right here.
pushes his brother into the egg. Okay. That's gonna be a really weird clip on the GoPro with no context. Huh. And we're in an area that nobody's been in for a very long time. It's a weird little carve out. Keeps going up that way. There's these little bump outs along the way. Oh, there's something cool. Like a tin of some sort.
That's cool.
It's an old canteen, I think. That is really cool. That's a man who's on level 900, doesn't want to get thirsty.
Oh, gotcha.
There's another can up there.
Now a line is fun.
You're all right. We're in a good spot, we can dodge them. And one takes me out, then I take mine out, we go to that back to the bottom. It's a quick way.
They keep going?
Yep.
Dang.
Throw that right there. Life. Well, there it is. Check out that. That's pretty sweet. All right. Ooh. I think that's... You want this, Brent?
You know, I was hanging out myself last
time. Can't quite have the muscle.
It takes.
How do you think it is if you're asking
me? I bet you that's every bit of 100 pounds. Nice work.
Take that.
And again. Flip it that way. The sign. Let's get it further up on that lip over there. There we go. I like that. Hold on. Grab a couple blocks if you can. Hold it. Got it.
Yeah, you're to the edge now, over here.
Perfect. Tip it up.
Yep.
How far can I that way?
You can keep going. I mean, it's over the lip, but...
One more big kick.
Yep. Yep.
Oh. Hell yeah.
The hoist has an ore cart in it once again.
Once again. All right, let's go on four.
So what do you think?
This was awesome. Best adventure yet today.
Heck yeah. We're going home with some decent treasure, I'd say.
Some great treasures.
This is probably the first time an ore bucket's ridden up on this hoist in 100 years.
All right, so we are on our way back up from level 900, and we ran out of room down in the main elevator. So I am currently riding on top.
Hey, there's still room for you. Come on down.
Is there? I don't feel like there was a ton of room left.
Yeah, I mean, you just have
Let's
to get closer.
What's going on down there?
Here's your
stuff. Brent, and we got the ore cart in there. There's a little bit of room, yeah. This is way more comfortable up here, I'm not going to lie.
Yeah.
Elevator's double-decker, and we are headed up to the top. We, what was that? Roughly almost 3 hours down there. The plan was like an hour. But we come bearing treasures, all sorts of fantastic treasures. We did not make it to the 1100 level, 1150, whatever it is. She's sticky. But our adventures here are not done. I think it's gonna come. We did actually find a huge chunk of galena, actually, and we should have brought the rock hammer
and
a canteen. So we got some mining to do, and the winch is just
Not sure how much it likes this or not.
Looks like it loves it.
So we're stuck at the 700.
Yeah, at least there's flags.
The hoist stopped.
Hey, can you hear us? The hoist stopped.
Yeah, we got you. We are spot right at the level 700 at the safety spot.
Can they see any damage on the rails above?
Can you guys see any damage on the rails above or? See if we can get it rolling again.
Yeah.
Radio check.
I can hear you.
Okay, we are all off the cart, so you're good to give it a shot again.
Say that one more time.
We are all off the cart, standing on level 700, so go ahead and try it again.
We're doing some oiling to make sure everything's functioning properly. Hang tight.
The only thing hanging tight right now is the elevator.
So they're about down 700 feet. They were on their way back up. They made it 200 feet up and the cages, or the cable is bound up.
But we can, that was cool.
Yeah, heck yeah.
Did you go down already?
No, they're oiling it up right now.
The rails will bow inwards and the cage will get stuck at that point. It'll go down easy enough.
Yeah, I copy you, go ahead.
If we can get it past that little bit, it'll come back up.
It's still below them.
Go, come up 10 feet! One more rat.
Go, so they're stuck 100 feet below where we can get to them.
Coming up 10 feet?
We're working on
coming up 10 feet.
Keep going, you're right at the rough spot.
We're past the rough spot, keep coming up!
Keep going!
No, keep...
Are you guys on board?
All on board, keep going.
Keep going!
Everybody! They're on board, keep going up!
All right, going up. All are on board, all are alive.
All alive, all on board.
Hell yeah.
Well, bail. Got another half hour, might as well go talk to the old ladies. I knew I could have ridden on the roof.
It's probably pretty gone. Dangerous though too, when you're working your way up and like a little rock works its way off.
Yeah.
Hits you in the head.
Yeah, you want a helmet for sure.
You should have gone down, yeah.
I know. Still can.
Except we definitely could have.
Yeah, Jim, just drive back with Hunter and go down.
So they're about 86 feet down now. And I can see them with my light now. And they're sitting on top of the cage that they rode down in, which means they've got something inside of the cage.
And
we knew there was an ore cart down there. And a bunch of other cool artifacts, but there's gotta be something pretty big for them to be on top of the cage. Otherwise, they would just be inside of the cage with whatever it is, so.
The equipment can handle it. Yeah. And I suspect that problem we had earlier might have something to do with them bringing an ore cart up.
Can we switch sides, me and you?
Yeah.
You're not filming, sir. Sunlight's gonna fuck up. Woo! Look, Captain.
Wow.
How was it?
Oh man. Oh man.
Keep coming up.
It was pretty incredible. That was wild. We found some cool stuff that we're bringing up. Yeah. I feel like a miner right now, just covered.
Yeah, like 17, 16.
Soot and grease.
Bring your old miner.
Say something for the camera, dude.
Good.
We're good. This is probably the largest artifact taken out of the Union Mine, at least during my time here.
Wow.
But when you asked, hey, did you pick up any extra weight?
Oh, we knew what you did.
Tim, look at the jack, too.
Tim was like, there's an old mining cart down there. I bet they grabbed it. And I was like, knowing my bosses, they 100% grabbed it.
Down, bros.
It was a bit of a fight.
Oh, yeah, Jim. We could have taken you and your whole extended family.
Real ram right there. Whoa. Helmet coming down.
That's crazy. Hey, guy.
Go, Diesel Dave!
Thanks.
Oh!
We did it!
Treasure!
We got some loot. We explored every square inch of the 900 level, and that place is incredible. I feel like I just came through a time machine.
A lot down there.
A lot going on, and
900 feet down on a 150-year-old lift.
Yeah,
it's a pretty good day.
We found an ore cart, which is still inside there. You'll see here some B-roll.
A little bit heavy to carry out the door.
Found this jack, which is also not super light. Found some drill bits.
A pick. Picked out this galena.
Yeah, we actually used this to pick out.
We mined.
Carbide tin, so some carbide in it.
Who got the dynamite? Anybody pick up the dynamite?
We were all too scared to grab the dynamite. I got to do some research on what makes dynamite blow up. So,
should I pick up
that,
a dynamite?
Because there's like 10 full there's sticks of dynamite. We found a lot of collapses. We found some areas where if we went and spent some time digging, we could probably make it through a little further. But man.
Lots of shiny rocks.
Yeah, lots of shiny rocks. Look at how shiny that rock is. Did I get any glitter in my beard?
Yeah, I think I got some too. I think the biggest win today though is we put the hoist to a pretty good test.
Yeah.
We know what the hoist is capable of. What do you think? Was she maxed out?
Did it really stop it dead?
It stopped it. I didn't stop it, it stopped. It started to shake.
Really?
And the pressures were fluctuating like 800 to 1,000 and then it stopped.
Really?
I bet we had 1,000 pounds on there.
Yeah, so what happened is that happened right before, that happened about 15 feet shy of level 700. So I was riding on the roof. I jumped off, Dave then climbed through the roof, jumped off. Finally, Brett came through. Once we got our weight off, it was enough to kind of push through that sticky spot. Because the problem is those timber guide rails, at one point it was grease, now it's tar. So it was literally just like pine sap holding us. So.
And right there bows out just a little bit, so it pinches.
Another one right above 200.
Yeah, right there, yep. It was a smooth ride. That was, we were down there for quite a bit longer than we anticipated. We told the boys here that it would be trouble if we were there more than like an hour and a half. We ended up being like roughly 3 hours.
It's almost 7.
Yeah, we went down to 245. That was incredible, dude. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
I'm like honored to be able to have been part of that. You'll see the footage. We got real creative trying to lift that ore cart because the hoist stops about right here from ground level, and then the rest is just a bunch of pile of garbage. So
we built a nice wobbly Jenga.
Yeah, we created like this little Jenga system that we walked it up, got it on, and now that's a piece of history that's going to go straight to the museum.
Awesome. That was the biggest, like I said, the biggest treasure I've pulled out of the museum.
This is also fairly big. Anyways, hugely successful day here at Cerro Gordo. Totally unexpected for all of us. The fact that Brent didn't know we were coming with a truck, the fact that we didn't know Brent was going to be able to get the guys here to come help run the hoist. So big shout out to the fellas here. You guys are awesome.
Yeah, thank you.
Big shout out to Brent for letting us, you know, invade your town. And this is just the beginning. We still got a lot of work to do here. And after being down there, we got some ideas. In fact, I think we're going to cut from this straight to a call out. We filmed a little video down there for, he's a guy that's kind of got a little bit of a following on YouTube.
He's starting off.
Without further ado, we're gonna go ahead and cut right into that. Ladies and gentlemen, we are currently 900 feet below the surface of the earth in the Union Mine here at Cerro Gordo, California, and we've got a call out. We got a challenge for the one and only Mr. Beast. Listen, Mr. Beast, we know you're competitive. We know that you love these challenges where it's the last man standing, but we also know that you don't always get to participate in your own challenges. So we're putting one on for you. We want you to come out here to the mine and compete against myself, my best friend Diesel Dave, and the one and only Mr. Brent Underwood to see who has the balls to stay underground the longest. No watch, no phone, no communication with the outside world. You will literally have no idea what year it is. Mm-mm. So are you in?
Or are you in?
This is what we need everybody to do. Tag him, call him, fax him, email him. Whatever you got to do to get Mr. Beast's attention, we want that man to come prove that he's really as competitive as he says he is, right here at the home of Mr. Brent Underwood at Cerro Gordo, California. So hit my pager and let's line this up. Brakes just went out. I think like, they went from on to completely gone. So
and this guy was a champ at driving. You should have seen it.
All of our lives.
Some of the best driving once again by Heavy D.
We were just doing some carving. We had to literally.
Wild bull ride.
Yeah. Only way Hunter was in the back. Only way we could stop was literally by carving.
I thought he was just trying to Hunter out.
I thought you were just being a freaking.
I know, everyone's like, hey, what are you doing?
Hunter's in the back.
I threw it in park, like, within the first couple seconds.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
You were trying to reach over there and pull it in park.
Oh, no, I put it in park right away.
You put it in park, and you were like, Dave, and he's like, brakes are out, and I was like, Hunter's gone, I'm gone, everyone's gone.
We were out of luck there for a second.
I was hanging out with an Australian guy all the time.
Woo!
Okay, pump it a little bit. Close
it.
Pump it.
Close it.
Okay.
Okay, let's do the other side.
All clear.
He's black or white.
Right.
He's a scaredy cat.
Getting pressure back?
Yep, getting some pressure back. We boiled the fluid in the calipers because obviously we got seven dudes in here and a bunch of gear, so we're super heavy and this is a super steep grade. And I wasn't riding the brakes, I was just kind of like, you know, on and off, but.
You did great, man.
You did great.
Close.
Alex, yeah, close.
Give me the donut.